Hey guys, Peter here to do an album review. Today I'm here to tell you all about Dawn of Disease's latest album, Procession of Ghosts, out November 1st on Napalm Records. The album has 8 tracks, 40 minutes in length, and this is the band's 5th full-length studio album. You can pick up the record with 2 bonus tracks, which brings the total to 10 songs, 51 minutes in length, and those bonus tracks are In Death We Blast and Hypnosis. In a year filled with great albums, there's always room for one more, just like dessert. And this album, in my opinion, is that one more. You really have to pay attention to this record. You really have to give it some consideration when you're putting together a top 10 list or your favorite albums of 2019. This album has a lot to offer, perhaps hidden under the surface, but there's definitely lots of layers to this album and there's a lot to talk about. Let's get right into it. So to me, this is an album that really blends structure and sound together. These two are intertwined from the beginning of the album all the way to the end and really gives the record fluidity. What they do on this album is absolutely amazing. The combination of structure and sound is layered multiple times under different parameters. So if you're looking at the overall album, you have to look at two lines. The first line being aggression, the second line being melancholy and intensity. While aggression stays steady throughout the whole album, the line that represents melancholy and intensity goes up and down, up and down, up and down. It goes like that all the way through the record. But then when you look at the individual structure of the record, the same is true. You have aggression that stays steady, and then you have the other line that mixes intensity and melancholy going up and down, up and down, up and down. So the overall structure of the record is also represented in the individual structure of the tracks. To me, that is fundamental on the way the album sounds, on the way it comes across, and overall how it works. I absolutely love the fact that you have a record that has an overall structure represented across 10 individual tracks. Love it. I absolutely love that approach. It really brings a lot of life, a lot of energy to this album. On top of that, they did a magnificent job mixing different elements like rock riffs, like melodic black metal riffs, sounding riffs. Specifically, if you're looking at songs like Shrine, the way that song opens, it has really this rock, blackened rock opening riff. Then they also added symphonic elements. If you look at Processions of Ghosts, for example, the symphonic elements that are present in that song really gives the song a lot of melody. It really expands the walls of the song. It really allows that track to go into different directions. So this is a record where they were not afraid to experiment with different styles, with different genres, incorporate little pieces here. They didn't go over the top, they didn't really go crazy on the record, but they allowed it to have these different elements sprinkle in throughout 10 tracks that allows the overall album to feel very dynamic, to have these ebbs and flows, these up and down feelings. Absolutely magnificent. It just gives a lot of life to the record. It never lets the listener feel comfortable because while the album is moving up and down, it's never moving sideways. So you're always going forward. You are moving up and down overall, but then you're also having that feeling, that roller coaster vibe of a feeling on an individual track basis. Really love that. And to me, that's all about how they combine structure with sound. Going into vocals, this is an album that, in my opinion, holds constant throughout. This is another element with aggression that I really feel that never dips, it never goes away, it never strays. It's very constant from the beginning all the way to the end, very heavy, very dark, very somber, perhaps the perfect companion for the overall mood that this album has to offer to the listener. I really love the enhancement that the vocals give to the music, to the tracks, and to the overall atmosphere of the album. On the guitar side, I really want to break the guitars away from the overall sound because I really feel the guitars on this album deserve a mention. I love the solos, I love the melodies, the riffs, the transitions. The overall guitar work on this album is magnificent. You can feel a little bit of that old school Swedish mellow death sound present onto this record on how the guitars are put together. But I just absolutely love what they did with the guitars. They really expanded on the sound of the guitars, allowing the sound sometimes to feel a lot bigger, to have a lot more volume, and just really break the walls and expand the sound of the overall album. Just, there's no limits for this record. There's really no boundaries to the sound, to the feel, to the mood that this record has to offer, and a lot of that is coming from the guitars and how they were put together throughout the record. As far as songs are concerned, I want to start with May the Waves Take Me. A lot of the songs, this one is one of them, but a lot of the songs on this record really, musically, really represent well the title of the track and the lyrics of the song. This song musically really feels like the waves of the ocean hitting the shoreline, coming up the sand, going back down, coming up the sand, going back down. It has that feel to it. The way the music is put together, the way the song is structured, it really has that vibe to it. It has a great guitar melody to open it off. Once the vocals come in, you really get that sense of the coming and going and that opening period of the track. You really feel that from the way the sound comes together, but also the way the vocals work. There's some more heavier and driven moments. The opening melody that this song has comes back again in the chorus. It gives the chorus life. It gives the chorus energy. It's a song that has a pattern and it follows it, but changes it and morphs it as it follows it along. It doesn't stay rigid to it. It morphs it as it follows along. There's a bass bridge in the middle of this track that I absolutely love. I love how it starts with a bass bridge, then it merges into, it adds on, it doesn't merge, but it adds on a guitar melody, and then it brings in the vocals. And then it goes back again to the original pattern, the original structure that the song has. But that middle portion there, it resets the track, it resets the sound, and it resets your ears. It allows for the second half of the song to feel even heavier than the first half of the song. Another track I want to mention is As Heaven Shatters, another song that really is represented musically very well when you think about the title of the track and when you think about the lyrics. This song almost feels like a thunderstorm, like the skies are crackling. There's a storm brewing in the horizon. It's coming towards you. You feel that musically. Listen to this track. So when you think about that, when you think about the lyrics, and then when you think about the title of the song, everything makes sense. Everything is intertwined. I really like the opening riff of this track. And more important, I like the fact that they kept it throughout the song. It has a very black metal fragrance to it. Almost a blackened rock and roll guitar riff to open up the song. And like I say, they keep that riff throughout the song. It really adds something different to this track. The drums are absolutely relentless. They're the perfect partner, in my opinion, to this blackened melodic guitar riff that fills the song. I really feel the two really work well together, and polar opposites, but really working well together. The vocals add darkness to the track. They add a melancholic feel at times, but mostly darkness to the song, and I really like that. In a song that has a lot of aggression, that has a lot of melody, you really need something that brings the mood down, that brings the song down, and in my opinion, that it's done by the vocals on this track. This song also has one of my favorite solos on the album. I like the fact that the solo pulled more out of the melodic portion of the track, not as much out of the melancholic or more aggressive parts of the track. Last but not least, In Death We Blast. This is one of the bonus tracks. This song features two guest vocalists. It features Andreas Bjornsson and Jason Netherton. So you have three different vocalists on this track. If that's not power, if that's not changing dynamics, if that's not creating something different, something new, I don't know what it is. This song is a powerful, powerful track, both musically and vocally. Obviously, the addition of two vocalists adds life to the song. It adds presence. It allows them to change the tempo of the song just by changing who the vocalist is. It really changes the dynamic. It really changes the parameters of the track. It's a track that flows extremely well, but it's a track that bends. In my opinion, this is a song that, while having a structure and while following a path, it just feels like it's bending on every single turn. It never feels necessarily that you know what's coming next. Perhaps the path is one of being unknown, because you just never really feel comfortable with this track. You never really understand exactly when is the solo coming. Is there a bridge happening after the? Is there a pre-chorus coming now? You never really feel comfortable with the track because there's just so many moving pieces. Having three vocalists add to that controlled chaos, if you will. And this song is really about controlled chaos. That's the overall feel that you get from this track, from the sound, from the vocals, from everything. There's just so much, but it never feels like the band is losing control of it, but it feels like controlled chaos. There's a portion on this song where you get this drum beat that feels like a marching band. I absolutely love that. It was so different from everything else. It was so different from all the elements that were given to you within this song. I really like that. It just had such a magnificent aroma. It just gave a different presence to the song. How the vocals worked with it also worked extremely well. This track also has a magnificent solo. It adds so much atmosphere to the song. It just adds so much power to the song. It doesn't take anything away. It just flows in and out perfectly of the track. It's a perfect addition to the way this track is. But this is a track that just bends sound at every single turn. both musically and vocally. You just feel like you're getting twisted and turned at every single with every single second that goes by once you start listening to this song. All right, guys, this is it. This is Dawn of Disease, Procession of Ghosts, out November 1st on A&P-REACTS Records. Let me know your thoughts on the band, on the singles. Use the comment section below, as always. Let me know those thoughts, and I'll be reading them and getting back to you as soon as I can. Take care, guys.